There are tons of crypto wallets for you to choose from. When it comes to protecting your crypto, you need to be 100% sure you're using something safe and secure. In today's video, I'll be taking a look at the Tangem wallet and why it is one of my top picks for 2024. And this isn't a sponsored video, it's my honest opinion on the wallet. Full disclosure though, Tangem did send me one of these for free and I started using it to store some of my crypto. So, let's break it down and see just how good it is. Security is the most important aspect of your cold wallet and should be your first priority. Tangem's approach to cold wallet storage is different from anyone else on the market. They don't use seed phrases. Seed phrases have inherent risks. If someone gets a hold of your seed phrase, that's it. They can get anything and everything from your wallet. Tangem doesn't base its security on a seed phrase though. It's a private key that is generated on this card. When you purchase your Tangem wallet, you can choose to get 2 or 3 cards. The extra cards are your backups, so it's more secure to get 3 as then you'll have 2 backups. These cards don't yet have a private key as they aren't activated. When you activate your card, the Tangem chip inside will generate a private key using a certified true random number generator, or a TRNG for short. This private key isn't known by anyone or anything, and it will never leave the card's chip. So to activate the card, you download the Tangem app and create a new wallet. All you do is tap one of the cards on your phone, you then create your own access code to access your wallet. This can be any word, phrase, or number of your choosing. Access codes add another layer of security, even if someone got one of your backup cards, downloaded the app and activated the near-field communication, they would still need the unique access code that you created. So even if someone has one of your cards, you're still safe, unless your access code is something silly like password or 0000. Tangem also has gone pretty heavy on security for the chips inside the cards. They have EAL6 plus chip protection. That's the same level of chip protection used in diplomatic passports and higher than most other hardware wallets on the market. They have the highest possible IP68 environmental protection rating, making it safe from dust, water, and hacking attempts. It can perform down to minus 25 degrees Celsius and up to 50 degrees Celsius. And if that wasn't enough, it's also protected from electromagnetic pulses, electrostatic discharge, and X-rays. With a guaranteed life expectancy of 25 years, these cards are pretty resilient. There are 2 points of vulnerability in this process though. You have to use the Tangem app on your phone to create these wallets, so your phone is their first vulnerability. You need to make sure your phone hasn't been compromised with malware. The other vulnerability is being online and connected to the internet. This one is easier to solve though. Just put your phone on airplane mode when you're making the connections with your cards. The wallet itself is still cold though, because it's on a card that never connects to the internet. You do have the choice to use seed phrases with Tangem, which they recently introduced. They don't recommend it, and I actually think their private key process is undoubtedly the best choice. So overall, I give the security on Tangem a 9.5 out of 10. It's not quite a full 10 because of the small human error element when setting up the wallet. Having access to a wide range of cryptos on your wallet is another crucial factor. If there isn't support for a wide range of cryptos, it's not very useful. Fortunately, Tangem currently supports 38 crypto networks, with even more on the way. That means there are literally thousands of tokens you can store in their wallet, and you can add custom tokens if they aren't on the list. Tangem also has a Wallet Connect enabled with their app. This gives you compatibility with a bunch of different dApps. So you can connect to sites like PancakeSwap and OpenSea and use your Tangem wallet assets with these sites. I always want to see more networks on wallets, but the coverage they have right now is impressive. So Tangem gets an 8 out of 10 for compatibility. The Tangem app is going to be your primary interaction with Tangem, so its functionality and usability is very important. Setting up the wallet is a ridiculously easy process. I finished mine in under 3 minutes, including the 2 backups. There's no seed phrase either, so this is a very noob-friendly experience. The interface itself is simple and easy to use. You can see all the crypto you hold and their current value, as well as the chains that Tangem have enabled. You can even buy, sell, and swap from within the app, and they also have staking on the way. There are several useful settings as well. You can hide the amounts on screen so people can't see what you hold. There's also a dark and light mode. But where the app really sets itself apart from others is the fact that you can use it as an on and off ramp. Yeah, you heard that right. This is obviously a little bit dependent on your country, but if your country allows it, you can convert crypto into fiat currency and feed it right into your bank account. The same goes for buying crypto using your card. Take a look at Mercurio and MoonPay services in your country to see if it works for you. But overall, this app doesn't overwhelm you, and it gives you a bunch of utility that makes it one of the better wallet apps I've come across. It's a solid 8 out of 10 for me. Look, customer support isn't something people think about until they need it. And ultimately, that is why I think it's incredibly important. When you need to get in touch with someone, it's important that you're able to. Tangem is one of the few crypto wallet companies that have a live chat on their website 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. I've tested it out a few times at different hours and always got a response within 10 minutes, but usually just a minute or two. But that's not to say it's perfect, but the fact that they have put resources into providing strong customer support is really good to see. There is also support within the app itself, and the average response time I saw was under 5 minutes. Plus, they also have access to support through Telegram and an extensive help center on their website. Between all of these, you are probably going to find the help you're looking for. So for me, that means Tangem gets a 9 out of 10 for customer support. Crypto wallets can get pretty pricey pretty quickly. I looked into the Engrave earlier this year and it starts at $398. The Ledger Stacks comes in at $279 and the Trezor Model T is around $219. So you might expect Tangem to be fairly expensive, but this isn't the case. For 3 cards, it will cost you $70, or you can get a 2-card set for $55. You can get 10% off by using the code LADY at the checkout too. Ultimately, the Tangem doesn't have some of the functionality that the Engrave and others have, but there's a case to be made that it doesn't need that functionality, as it's mostly on the app. So the Tangem comes in at a decent price point, though you're essentially buying a card with NFC capabilities, which shouldn't have a big price tag. So for me, the price comes in at a solid 8 out of 10, but with the discount, maybe an 8.5. When you buy your Tangem, you will be able to choose from 2 or 3 cards. These additional cards serve as your backup. You then create backups of your wallet by tapping the other cards on your phone when prompted. It gets pretty techy with the details here, but essentially there are some unique keys on these cards that establishes a chain of trust between the primary wallet card and the backup cards. It uses something called a Diffie-Hellman key exchange protocol. Basically, the tech inside the chips means that Tangem is able to verify you are actually using a Tangem wallet as a backup. The private keys in the cards never leave the card's chips, so there is no way for anyone to access them. Even if they get your backup card, they need your access code in order to get in. So just make sure your access code isn't something stupid or simple. The avoidance of seed phrases means that these backups are actually really safe. The human error element is reduced because no one can get their hands on anything you've left lying around to gain access. And because the cards get activated when you tap it onto your phone, Tangem themselves don't know what the private key is. So there is no vulnerability from the supplier side having a database of private keys or anything. But if you somehow lose all of your cards, then you will lose access to all of your funds. Again, this comes down to an element of human error. You need to store your backup cards in a safe place and ideally in different locations. If you lose your phone, that's fine. The phone doesn't hold any crypto, so all you need to do is tap your card or backup cards onto another phone and you'll be able to access everything. Overall, the backup option for me comes in an 8 or 9 out of 10. When it comes to design, Tangem has gone for a pretty minimalist approach. There's only so much you can do with a card, and Tangem have decided to go for a sleek, refined look. You can see that the card is a pretty standard size that will fit into any regular wallet. It's not a metal card, so it isn't heavy, but there's a nice weight to it that means it doesn't feel too flimsy. Compared to the old version of Tangem, I much prefer the look and feel of the new version. It's a bit sturdier than the previous one. It would be cool to have some choice when it comes to the different design of the card. Some different patterns or personalizations would give it a bit more character. For me, the minimalist and sleek look gives it a 7 out of 10. Open source is really important to me when it comes to wallets. Community oversight for applications is really important, both for improvements and transparency with the customer base. Fortunately, Tangem's app is fully open source, which is a big plus. Finding updates and a roadmap is a bit of a different story though. They are constantly working on updates like staking, adding new networks, and cross-chain swaps, but there is no roadmap on their site, which I think is something they could improve on. Keeping people informed and excited about the future is always a good thing in my book. I don't know exactly what's coming though, so I have to dock some points for that, making it an 8 out of 10. Overall, the Tangem wallet gets a decent 8 out of 10. This is a wallet that keeps things simple, at the same time as giving you a whole bunch of utility within the app. The security and lack of seed phrases sets it apart from other wallets. Most cold wallets haven't gone with the approach Tangem has, but I think theirs is really effective. It's very noob-friendly, quick and easy to set up, and it's not a bulky machine that is annoying to carry around. If you like this review, please give the video a thumbs up and leave a comment below for a wallet you'd like me to look at next. If you want to get your hands on a Tangem wallet, you can use the link below and get 10% off using the code LADY at the checkout. If you want to see more wallets, you can check out my last review on Engrave just below. But until next time, guys, remember, trade smart, don't be a dumbass, and I'll see you soon.